Hello everybody and welcome to Luxury Benefits channel. My name is Sviatoslav and in this video we will talk about vision recovery exercises like distance switching exercise, play the trombone exercise, clockface exercise and roll your eyes slowly exercise. Distance switching exercise. You can change focus between the close one about 25 centimeters or 10 inches from the eyes and distant at a distance of more than 5 meters or approximately 17 feet objects. The easiest way to do this exercise is by holding in front of the bridge of the nose finger. From it, you need to look at the different objects that are at different angles and relatively different distances from you. For example, you can look at your finger and look at object in front of you, then from your finger to look at the floor, then from your finger look on the ceiling, then your finger and the object to the right, then on your finger and anything at your left. At the end, you should look again in the finger and at the object in front of you. Change focus every 3 seconds, but always return to fingers as a starting point. This exercise can be done outdoors or in the car while you are in a traffic jam, but it's better to do it indoors. Any items that suitable as remote objects. For instance, can change focus between finger and TV, room corners, floor, ceiling, etc. Play the trombone exercise. Hold an object at arm length in front of you, such as thumb, pencil or keychain. Breathe deeply and slowly while inhaling. Move the object toward face until touches the bridge of the nose. When exhaling, withdraw the object again at arm length. Keep looking at the object, slowly moving it back and forth in time with the breath. When you move your thumb or other object close to nose, it goes out of focus and can be double. Try to avoid this by looking at the smallest details on the object, such as the tip, nail, pen or candle wick. Strive to move your hand slower and slower as soon as the image starts to break or lose focus. When retracting an object, it also need to be moved very slow. In people with nearsightedness, the subject may lose focus as if bringing it close to the nose and at arm length. In my opinion, this exercise is an excellent prevention of hyperopia and trains the eye's ability to converge or note. All people have this ability from birth, as well as the ability to accommodate, ability to keep eyes on the bridge of the nose. We need to do it small jobs at a close range. Do you remember this? What are you writing there with your nose? As a result, the ability to switch distance is weakening, and after 45 years, everyone is offered use plus points. People sometimes say at a doctor's appointment, "Doctor, I see I'm fine, only now my hands are short." It's awkward to keep it so far book while reading. Therefore, for those who already wear plus glasses, this exercise is not given right away. Difficulty keeping eyes on the bridge of the nose and painful reaction in the eyes at the same time. That's why American doctors recommended to do it slowly. Clockface exercise. Look at a distant object in front of you, imagining that you are standing in front of a large cone-shaped clock with a remote stretched forward center. The head and shoulders do not move. Take your eyes from the center to imaginary number 9, which is on the side of your left ear. Then return your eyes to the distant center and gently move eyes for a couple of seconds in the direction of the number 10, as if you tried to see something above the left ear. Come back again with the gaze to the center. Also look at the imaginary number 11 and continue move slowly around all digits and to the center, smoothly moving your eyes to the next hour digits and then returning to the distant center, such as unusual tapered dial. In my opinion, the main value of this exercise is not only in its originality, but also in the fact that it includes all three groups of oculomotor muscles at the same time. Doctors basically don't have dividing exercise into groups depending on the type of movements committed by the eyes. Nevertheless, I find this exercise the most original that doctors and gladly propose a walkthrough such as an imaginary dial. Roll your eyes slowly. Roll your eyes slowly, making a full circle, at first into one side, then to the other. This exercise has been widely known for a long time, therefore I understand why it was included in the list of new visual skills. I can only add that such rotation cannot be done quickly. It is important to monitor coordination and control movement by producing slow, smooth rotation without jerking and small discrete movements. At the same time, doesn't need to look at nothing definite. Just imagine a large dial and slide smoothly across in one direction and then to the other. Some warnings should be made about eye movement by clockwise and counterclockwise rotation of the eyes. You should not strain the extraocular external muscle of the eyes to the limit. It's better to relax your eyes as much as you can and do not overload the retina. The goal of the exercise is to develop smooth, controlled movements of eyes rather than develop stronger muscle, so don't overdo it. Rolling the eyes sometimes causes nausea or dizziness. In that case, you need to close your eyes and perform the exercise with your eyelids closed. Blink and breathe slowly. Breathe slowly and deeply. Don't look at anything when inhaling certain, but just do a few normal blinks, completely filling the lungs with oxygen. Then close your eyes and slowly exhale all the air from your lungs. When exhaling air, do not do nothing with your eyes, no movements of your eyes. Just leave them slightly covered and relaxed and blink slowly as you inhale. For greater effect, I suggest close eyes during exhalation and imagine how they're slightly deflating balloons. This image personally helps me to relax much faster and in the end yawning. And this is the best proof that you relax at not only with your eyes, but also the jaws and muscle of the entire face. Therefore, if during any relaxation exercise you need to yawn, this will give you very good and quick relaxation effect. If you can't yawn, release your lower jaw and inhale forcefully through your mouth. For this will surely be followed a prolonged yawn. Thanks for watching this video to the end. Today we learn switching focus exercise. Play the trombone exercise, cone-shaped clock exercise and full circle exercise. I hope it will help you and we'll see you again in my next videos.